Hi guys, we're gathered here today to say goodbye to an old friend, NBA 2K. Is headed to the graveyard of basketball developers. And what even makes it worse, NBA 2K doesn't really produce anything other than NBA 2K. They produce WWE 2K Wrestling, and they might do something else. They had some kind of version of baseball that was resurrected for the platform PS4 and Xbox 360 and Xbox One and all that, but it didn't work. I think I may have that wrong with the baseball. But I'm moving this around so it won't go into a demo game. And I'm going to get out of it real soon by going to the features here and switching down. And that's not what I wanted to do. A lot of problems with this game, glitches and such. And this is part of the problem of why so many have decided to part ways with NBA 2K20 this year. NBA 2K used to be a true rebel of the developers, of the AAA developers. They did everything to knock down the giant, which was EA Sports, and they succeeded. They succeeded so well that in 2020, EA Sports decided, no moss. We're not going to even make a game this year to compete with NBA 2K20. Why? Because NBA 2K20 went for their jugular vein and introduced that they were going to have the WNBA on NBA 2K20. Not only were they going to have the WNBA on NBA 2K20, they already had college basketball. Yeah, that's right. College basketball on their game. Nobody else was even touching this college game thing. And 2K managed to still have the roster share where you could download all of these uniforms for college teams and download all the rosters for college teams. Beautiful. This is what made them the king. But the killer blow to EA Sports was because EA had moved into, okay, for a while, they wasn't allowing any player movement in their rosters. So then they said, we better do something. We're going to lose the audience completely. So they let us move players around, which was cool, right? But then NBA 2K came along and put the college game back in to their game. You didn't have to go out and buy college hoops. College hoop was included in your NBA 2K game, whatever year it was, 17, 18, or 19. This was like taking a slap in EA all in the face. So what did EA Sports do? 2018, I think? They introduced that they were going to put into their game the WNBA. We'll get the female crowd. That was the thinking. And those who like watching the females play in college and in the professionals. We'll draw some of these people to our game. And it worked. They put the WNBA in. Their sales went up a little bit. So they were doing something that the general public liked. Now keep in mind, 2K still had that college game, plus the regular NBA season, plus the My Career, all of this stuff. So then in NBA 2K20, they decided, let's go for the jugular vein on EA Sports and NBA Live. They decided to put the WNBA into 2K, into the 2K game. So they had the college game and the women's basketball league in their game now. And all Live had was regular rosters, some player movement, and the WNBA. So, that was just a killing blow, man. A knockout. They knocked them out. So much so that NBA Live 20 was rumored to not going to be. That was bad grammar, I know. But in the summer of 2019, there was a minor panic among NBA Live fans saying, oh, there's not going to be they should have released it by, some little clips or something of NBA Live 20. And everybody started getting worried in the NBA Live community that there was going to be no NBA Live this year. And lo and behold, when October, late September rolled around, there was no NBA Live 20. So, NBA 2K20 sat on the mountaintop, you understand? And said, we are the king. That's the way we say it in the urban areas. The king, not the king, the king. In other words, and the women will say they the queen. Not the queen, the queen. So NBA 2K20 said, we got them now. We got them by the kahunis. So they just rushed their game out and they said, we'll patch it as we go. And they'll take it because they're just suckers. I don't know if they said that now, but that's what it feel like they said. And they threw up some stuff. You know what I mean when I say stuff. And see if it would stick to the wall. And sure enough, the sales were great. But ooh, baby. When the word got out, the game was crashing. It wasn't playing right. You had to keep uninstalling, reinstalling it. Oh, and the word got out, and it didn't get no better. By the holiday season, it wasn't even better. Oh, that's when the major creators of YouTube content started abandoning the game. And see, YouTubers are the number one advertising for any video game. That's 101. Video game developers 101. Somebody getting ready to develop a game. If you don't have your game on YouTube, it ain't going nowhere. Okay? So, and I mean, there's some big wigs that dropped NBA 20 this year. They dropped them like a hot rock. So, what's the point of this video? Well, the point of this video is to say goodbye to an old friend. NBA 2K and Take-Two did a phenomenal job. I'm saying from 2008, so that would be 12 years, which is about almost the same run that NBA Live had before people start bitching and moaning about it. Okay? So maybe that's when they run up against a wall after 12 years. I don't know. But I think it's because you took the people for granted. You said, whatever we dish out, we're the king. They'll take it and they'll like it. That's like Marie Antoinette said. They told Marie Antoinette, they said, the people are hungry, Queen Marie Antoinette. She said, let them eat cake. Ain't that something? And that's what NBA 2K said to you guys and me. Let them eat cake. They'll be around. They're suckers. They'll keep coming to us. And there's no other game out there for NBA. But they didn't understand that they crushed some people. The content creators on YouTube, the guys in the online blacktops, they crushed these people because the game was crashing, the updates were too many, and they weren't doing anything, and the guys were complaining to you, and you didn't listen. And now, if EA Sports, if I was at EA Sports, oh, doctor, we'd be back in business. I would be trying to come out with an NBA Live game in February after the All-Star game. I'm sure they had NBA Live 20 in development, but they said no moss when NBA 2K said they was going to have the WNBA in their game. And they just said, it ain't no use. Nobody's going to buy our game. They'll buy it now if you put it out and you put in the things that NBA 2K20 didn't do, where you got to updates are coming at you every 5 minutes. Microtransactions are being tossed in your face every 5 minutes. If you can make a game, NBA Live, right now, without all those microtransactions, where you can move, have player movement, where you can have roster sharing, and you can do the same thing that NBA 2K did with the college game and NBA Live game, you're back. You will be the king of video game basketball once again, because my friends at NBA 2K got the big head. They thought they was the king, and they're not the king. They ain't even the prince now. People have dismissed this game. People are actually reloading NBA 2K18, which was horrible, and reloading NBA 2K19, which was horrible, because they want to have a good basketball game without all the glitches, without all the crashes, without all of the microtransactions. Well, they'll still get microtransactions on 18 and 19. But they'd be a doofus to buy it now, because it's just no point in it. Just play the game and have fun with it now. So when you get to the point where people reject your game, the current generation of your game, in favor of a previous generation of your game, rip. Rest in peace. Because you didn't listen. And who's to blame? The little guys who work at 2K are to blame. Because they were scared to tell the big wigs at 2K. It's like the old story, there was an emperor that didn't have no clothes on. and he walked around, and everybody, oh, what a lovely outfit you have on today, King. And he was butt naked walking around. But they were scared to tell him he was butt naked. So, you know, they just would say nice things to him, flatter him. And that's what the little guys at 2K was doing. Flattering the king. You know, tell him, oh, anything, we need to do this. Oh, whatever you say. Oh, yes, 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 man. That's all they have at 2K now. Yes, man. They don't have no revolutionary developers there anymore. So the emperor with no clothes, one day a boy came up and he said, he don't have no clothes on. And everybody went, oh, because they thought that the king was going to kill him. And the king covered up his thing with his hand and ran back into the palace. I took artistic liberty with this story there. But that's about what happened. He was covering his crack with one hand and his thing with the other. Run back into the castle. Put something on. And that's what's happening to NBA 2K. They running into the castle with one, they right hand over their thing and they left hand over their crack and they rear end. Because they got embarrassed. So that's it, guys. I just wanted to say goodbye to this old friend because it'll never be the same. Once the people reject you, it's hard to come back. But now, NBA 2, NBA Live, it's your chance. I think if you can get a game in development, NBA Live 20, if you can get it and get all your bugs out that you were going to have in the game this year, put it out before the playoffs or right after the All-Star break, I think it'll be a real big seller for you. Because this game is broke. NBA 2K20 is broke. And they're offering all kind of little soft little things. They're throwing things at NBA 2K is throwing things at the 2K community. And they're just turning their backs on them. So that's it for this video, guys. And trust me. I've got over 1,000 videos of NBA 2K up on my channel. Understand this? This is for Take-Two and NBA 2K. If you guys want to leave now, that's fine. This is a special message for NBA 2K. I got all your college games up. College Hoops 7, College Hoops 8. When you started the new College Hoops series ingrained in your NBA 2K series, starting in 17, I got all that. So all in total, I got thousands of videos on NBA 2K. But right now, it's kind of hard to put your stuff up because nobody really wants to see it. They're so pissed off with you, they won't even watch the college games. They would rather watch EA Sports than to watch 2K's superior graphics in the college game. Just to show you, a person can look good, but if they're rotten inside, most people will notice that. If you get a beautiful woman and she's a no good, and you know she's no good, you'd rather have the plain girl or the homely girl than that be with that beautiful woman who's going to call you nothing but grief. And vice versa for the ladies. I'm not sexist. The ladies might, you know, a really handsome guy, but he's all about himself and thinking, oh, he's the king walking around here. Where's my food? Where's my, this Kool-Aid ain't cold enough. Take it back. that kind of stuff. No, 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 no. Hold on. Hold your horses. Then there's a little guy, a nerd over there. He's making $100,000 working with a computer company. All of a sudden, he walks into the holiday party with this beautiful woman on his arm. Why? Because that handsome dude didn't treat that girl right. And that's what's happened with NBA 2K. You didn't treat your customers right, and now they turn their backs on you. Big developers, I mean, big YouTube content creators have turned their backs on you. And you did it to yourself with all those microtransactions. YouTube has new rules now. You can't sell gambling to kids. And guess what? Microtransactions, whether you believe it or not, are gambling. It's teaching kids how to gamble. And all of that's coming back to slap you in the face. You're still my friend, though. I love your old-time games. I'm probably one of the few people that really will probably buy you next year if you come out with something else. Because I'm an old-time gamer. I really think your diamond in the rough every year is your old team rosters of old teams and your all-time teams. That's your diamond in the rough. That's a place where you can maybe salvage your audience, older gamers. You lost the young gamers. They moved on, been there, done that. Don't want to have nothing to do with you. And they paid $100 for your game this year, and they got a bunch of crap. All right, guys, that's it. Take it easy. Thanks for watching.